Dominic from BMT, and I will make a little video showing you four differences, important points between throwing a frisbee and playing a backhand slice. I made a comment on a video on internet that throwing frisbees to practice the backhand slice is not the same as playing the backhand slice because they are two different movements, two different motions. So I will show you four points which are for me important to show you why throwing the frisbee you cannot actually compare by playing the slice. Now, the first point, which will be the most important part, is how to start the position of the hand. So if I have my slice, I make a slice movement first, I start here, I go down and sideward in the frisbee, I go here and I go up and forward. So let's show the difference is the back of my hand is up in that slice and the back of my hand is on the side in that frisbee, which means that the frisbee will make a flexion and extension movement, where in the slice we will make that radial to ulnar deviation together with some supination. So if I come here, I have that supination, and here goes that radial to ulnar deviation. So that's very, very big difference. If I'm going to do a slice motion with my frisbee, yeah, first of all, I have to change the position of my hand. So I also have to change the position of the frisbee. And if I'm going to make a slice movement, yeah, that frisbee will go straight down to the ground. Where if I'm going with my slice, I'm going to take that frisbee position and I'm going to do the same, I will never have some slice. So the first point is already the biggest, but let's go to the second point, the point of release, yeah, or the contact point in that frisbee. I will release that frisbee here in front of me, and the back and slice, I will take contact closer to my front foot or my knee or my shoulder, depending on the coach, how she's explaining. And from here on, I go sideways. So if I'm going to release that frisbee on the point where I will make contact, yeah, then that frisbee again will go down straight to the ground. Where if I'm going to make contact with my slice, my racket is so open that that ball, yeah, will go high. And if I take it way in front, see, I'm hardly touching it and it's already going out. So this is the point two, the contact point close to the body or way in front of you. And point three is the follow through. Now, with that racket, the slice from contact, yeah, you are going down and sideways. You come here into contact and you go down and sideward. And with that frisbee, yeah, you go here and you go up and forward. So you can start here the same height, no problem, but you will go up, yeah. But if you keep going down, the frisbee will go down, so you are going up and forward. If I'm going to do that again with my backhand slice, yeah, and if I'm going in contact, I'm going up and forward. Again, this ball is going out, hardly touching it. Where if I'm going with the slice, I'm going to the side. This is a nice deep slice and has some punch, it has some speed. So this is the third difference. And the follow through is also actually point four, is because I'm going to the side that I make more speed. If I go to the side with my frisbee, yeah, and I pull more to the side, that frisbee has more speed. Where again, in that backhand slice, if I go forward and upward, yeah, no matter if I take the contact closer or further in front of me, if I go forward and upward, yeah, that ball goes out. So a recap, the four differences between throwing a frisbee and playing a backhand slice: the position of the hand, making a supination with radial to ulnar deviation or making a flexion and extension. The second point is the contact point, close to the body or way in front of the body. The third point, the follow through, is going up and forward or going down and sideways. And point four, if you go up and forward, you lose speed. If you go down and sideward, you gain speed. So these are for me four important points why throwing the frisbee is not a good practice to playing that backhand slice. So leave your comments behind. The only thing I can say, thank you for watching.